So today let's take a look at some sources of FreeWire. If you want to make your own DIY transformer, for example a switching one, or a classic one on an iron core, or some electromagnet or coil or inductor, or maybe a secondary for a Tesla coil, you have to get the wire from somewhere. Also, if you have to repair something with a faulty winding, you have to rewind it and you have to get the wire from somewhere. Of course, you can buy it, but it's also possible to get it for free. You can get a nice wire from a lot of trashed or broken devices for no cost. And of course, this is a wire for windings with a thin isolation on it. It's not a bare wire. It has some lacquer or enamel on it. So it's isolated. So let's take a look at the sources of the wire. One very common source of a wire is a deflection coil from CRT televisions or monitors. For example, this one is from an old television and it has two sets of coils. Horizontal deflection coils and vertical deflection coils. And a big enemy of you is now the resin. Those horizontal coils are actually in resin. It's rock hard. You can't unwind it without completely destroying it. But those vertical coils have no resin. The wire is loose on it and you can unwind it from it. If you remove this fried core with the wire, it then looks like this and it's possible to unwind it. This is a nice wire for windings. In some CRT monitors, unfortunately, both sets of coils are in resin. The horizontal one is in resin and the vertical one is also in resin. But there is also a rotation coil to rotate the picture to adjust it. And it's this one around it. And if it's removed, it looks like this. It's basically a spool of wire. And this wire has no resin in it. It's just loose wire. And you can easily unwind it. You can also get a nice wire from some transformers, as long as it's not in resin, but it's mostly not. Here you can see some transformers where the winding is just a loose wire and you can unwind it. You only have to disassemble the core. Sometimes the iron core of it is welded and you have to cut it, but sometimes it's just pieces of metal put together, but most commonly it's made of those metal pieces, those metal sheets, which are I and E shape. And it's usually assembled such a way that it's alternately stacked. One layer goes like this and the other layer goes the opposite way. So there is no air gap because transformers mostly have no air gap, unlike inductors which have to have an air gap to prevent saturation of the core. You basically have to pull those out one after another and then you get the winding from it. It's also possible to get a wire from some relays or contactors or electromagnets. And it's probably a bit easier to remove. And you can probably find an electromagnet even in a toaster or some other devices. There is also a coil in some water pumps or solenoid valves, but it's probably completely in plastic and it's not possible to take it out. Some transformers or coils are completely in plastic, so it's not possible to disassemble it, but some electromagnets or coils or relays or contactors have a spool of a wire. The wire is loose on it and it's basically as good as if you buy a spool of a new wire. And there is quite a lot of it in those relays or contactors, with a nice big coil. And there is also a nice coil in some motors, especially those microwave oven fan motors have a nice coil in it, which you can remove and use the wire because it's loose, with no resin. This one also has a nice wire in it, and this one has even a bigger coil. Those microwave oven fan motors are definitely one of the best sources of wire in modern electronics. Unfortunately, those motors from most of kitchen devices have the winding in resin. But let's check it. It can be easily disassembled and this one is definitely in resin and those ones? And those ones are a bit loose, but still probably contain some resin and they are not easy to remove, with no damage to the wire. The best ones are definitely the ones with a coil on a spool, which you can just remove and unwind with no problems. Like, for example, in this mechanical timer, those microwave oven fan motors and other devices with this kind of coil. Also, this water pump from a washing machine seems to have some nice coil in it, in its motor. Let's take a look. It definitely looks nice. It's a loose wire on those two coils in series, probably. Here's the rotor of it. Quite dirty, actually. It looks like it's a permanent magnet. So it's a synchronous motor. And the rotor is in the water and the coils are from the outside. So the water has no place to leak. Can I get the coil out somehow? And that's it. And now, well, that's a nice construction. And I have those coils. And there is a permanent magnet. It could even be a generator. And there is also a lot of copper wire in fluorescent tube inductors and discharge lamp inductors, but it's mostly in resin. Even though, once I managed to take this thick wire out of this big inductor for a mercury vapor discharge lamp, and I made a secondary for my vacuum tube Tesla coil out of it. It's a high frequency secondary with a thick wire on it. And there is also this coil of wire in every color CRT television or monitor. Every color CRT tube has this coil for demagnetization. It's a degaussing coil, which is briefly connected to mains. When you turn it on, it basically magnetizes the screen in such a way that it compensates the magnetic field of Earth. In this degaussing coil, there is quite a lot of turns of a wire, and it's briefly connected to mains, and then it's disconnected. Or actually, it's connected via an NTC thermistor, which gradually heats up, so the current gradually goes down in it. And this has the effect that it magnetizes the screen in such a way that it can compensate the magnetic field of Earth. So the colors of the color screen are not distorted. And of course I mean a PTC thermistor, its resistance goes up as it heats up, so the current in the coil goes down. And it's a very nice coil. And here's my dog. And what about this motor from some timer or something? Can I use some winding from it? Or can I even open it? Okay, so my battery just went flat, so the process of disassembly wasn't recorded, but I just removed the contacts, the holder of the contacts, this metal core from it, this shaft, and now the coil comes out. And it's possible to open it like this. And here's the winding, which is a very thin wire on a spool. It's almost like if you buy a new wire. This is really quite a nice source of a thin wire. So this is where to get the wires from, and this super thin wire is about 0.05 millimeters. From this big 60 volt relay it's about 0.12. And this microwave fan is about 0.15. Another microwave fan is 0.2. And this one has a bigger coil, it's 0.25. And this washing machine drain pump is also 0.25. A CRT rotation coil is 0.3. And the degaussing coil from the same monitor, 0.4. A small deflection coil from a CRT television, 0.3. And a bigger deflection coil from a CRT television is about 0.5 millimeters. And this transformer is about 0.7 millimeters. This small discharge lamp inductor is about 0.9 millimeters. And this big discharge lamp inductor is 1 millimeter. So this is Dayton Wild, and see you in my next videos. And thanks to all of my patrons on Patreon. I really appreciate your support. And of course, I'm going to use one of those wires to rewind the faulty coil of my vintage frequency meter.